but we have now become active, especially after the pandemic period started. And we are having a lot of activities now. We are organizing workshops, lecture demonstrations, and we are coordinating with various organizations to run festivals. We are supporting members to organize festivals, and we are now trying to find out a solution to get revenue for artists by having ticketed programs in whichever platforms is possible. And we are also trying to find out the possibility of creating our own platform to organize programs where artists can get the revenue. So Indian Classical Dancers Association, we have got a WhatsApp group of nearly 1,000 members now. So those who are not members now can just put down your number on the chat box so that we can add you to the group. So within 1 second, you can get anything done in USA, UK, Germany, or anywhere. Even Hong Kong, we have members. So anywhere in the world, we have got members. So that is the beauty of our organization, to help each other, to guide each other, assist each other, and to promote the talent of artists in the classical dance forms. So today we have one of the eminent Kuchipudi dancers, a dance teacher, choreographer, and I had been trying to get her for the last 1 year, but it was not convenient for her, or something was not connecting together. So now today we have Srimati Rama Devi from Hyderabad, and I am really happy that she is a native of Kerala, and she had been settled in Andhra, and she became in Andhra. Since she was there, she became an exponent of Kuchipudi. So on behalf of the association, may I welcome Srimati Rama Devi, and I would request Charanya, our host, to introduce Srimati Rama Devi. Charanya.
Thank you, Gopa sir. Namaskaram, Rama Devi ma'am. Namaste. And a very warm good evening to all the dancers who are present here around the globe. I think if not for the pandemic, I don't think all of us have surely got connected. Something really nice for the artists to be here. To just begin with, without taking much time, I would like to introduce Kalashri Srimati Rama Devi. Is a very well senior Kuchipudi dance exponent, and she is having many contributions in the field of Kuchipudi as a performer, guru, scholar, and an organizer. And just a kind request to all the participants, you can just stay on mute. Yeah, but then I will have to mute ma'am as well. Ma'am, just what I will do is I will just mute all of them for a few minutes, and yeah, then you can unmute yourself from your own. Yeah.
That's good.
Okay, so she is the artistic director of Sri Sai Nataraja Academy of Kuchipudi Dance, which is established in Secunderabad in the year 1989. Along with that, she's also a professor at the University of Silicon Andhra in California, USA. She has authored more than 6 books along with her PhD thesis on the comparative study of Chaturvidha Abhinaya between Kathakali and Kuchipudi, Yakshagana as a book. And she has conceived a CD and the ebook on Natya Shastra, which is titled Natya Shastra in a Nutshell. And she's had a credit of scripting more than 7 dance ballets, 5 songs, and many number of articles to many newspapers and prestigious magazines. A recipient of Kerala Sangeet Natak Academy Award, Kalashri Award, a recipient of Senior Fellowship from Ministry of Culture, New Delhi, the National Devadasi Samman, Rashtriya Jayadev Samman, Lifetime Achievement Award from Yuva Kalavahini. I think the list is just going on. Just to give you a recent acclamation to her, was she had received a special invitation from the President of India to attend the at-home reception at New Delhi. We are indeed honored to have such a great exponent amongst us who will be addressing on this topic of what is the lyrics and how do we portray a character in Natya. This Natya is where it's not only about just the physical dance, and how we get into the depth of a character before we present ourselves to the audience. That is the main crux of today's discussion. And as requested, I think she would be quoting a lot of inputs from the Natyashastra. So as artists, maybe if you all can note it down in a pen and paper or somewhere where you can have some gadget where you can note down the points that she would be discussing to us, would be beneficial for all of us as artists. And the next request is, we would like to address the questions at the end of the session. So I would request all of you to keep your questions ready as and when it is arising during the lecture demonstration, or you can also free feel to type out your questions on the chat box, and ma'am will be addressing the questions at the end of the session. So over to you, ma'am. A very warm welcome to you, and looking forward to this wonderful session today. You could unmute yourself and start talking so that.
Thank you so much. First, I have to thank Gopa sir for giving me this opportunity. Since a few years, I know him. A very passionate art lover he is, though he is not a dancer or any artist. He is more than that. So I thank you, Gopa sir, for giving me this opportunity. And Charanya, thanking you for those nice words about me. Now, I feel I always, still I'm a student, keep learning. There is no end for learning. So here I'm coming up, which is my favorite topic, and very concerned about the performance when I see Nritya, that is solo dancers, when we are doing characters. We forget that we are doing the character, we just do as the normal dance. So here I want to share, it's not my knowledge, what is written in Natyashastra, I just want to share you. We are doing the degrees, not the sake of the degree. These MAs or PhDs or BA, whatever it is, it came now. But from the long many years, it is the Guru Parampara, the Guru used to teach. Nowadays, no time for the Guru. Students, they cannot spend more than 1 hour. So even the guru is not able to explain them. So by introducing the degrees, people are doing the courses and they are learning the theory. And nowadays, in this modern era, people are so attracted to MBBS, engineering and other courses. Nobody much interested do these courses, or they are not getting time because they want to make their career too. I'm not finding fault in that. So this, like such lecture demonstrations or talks by experienced dancers really will help the young generation to learn the theory. So you all know, I'm starting my lecture here. We all know that all the classical dance, has esteem, honor, because it is very ancient and it follows the Shastra. That is why the classical dance forms come under the category of Nibaddha, which means bind by a set of rules. So when anyone performing this Shastriya Nritya, that is our 9 classical dance forms, they have to follow the Shastra that are laid down in the book, especially the Natyashastra. So every classical dancer must have the thorough knowledge of this great text, which reveal the rules pertaining to the performance of drama, that is called Natya. In Natyashastra, Bharata mentioned 10 kinds of dramas, which are called as Dasharupakas. Dasha means 10. Rupaka. So what is Rupakam? Why Natya is called Rupakam? Let us understand. It is called Rupakam because Rupam Drishyata Yochate. Rupam Drishyata Yochate. It is reproduction of a situation in a visible form. Rupam means form. form means rupam. So you are able to see the rupam yourself on the stage. So hence Bharata defines. Hence Bharata defines Natya as Avasthanukruti Natyam. Avasthanukruti Natyam means it is an imitation of actions and conducts of people which is rich in various emotions and which depicts different situations. So the act performed, word uttered, or even a garment worn, all must be exactly that of the character that we are going to present on the stage. The presentation of life or the character on the stage by the artist or actor should be realistic, which is called as lokadharmi. In rupakam, as soul entering the body of another, leaving aside its own, assumes the character of the other. That is what we are doing. In a drama, when we are doing a character, the actor conceals his form by dress and painting his body and assumes the form of the other whose form he has taken over. This is possible only in Ritya, where only one single person doing a single character. But when we are presenting in Ritya, a solo dance, only we in the classical dance costume, you have to depict so many characters without the support of Aharya Abhinaya. That is the four kinds of Aharya Abhinaya elements are Pustha, that is accessories, Anga Rachana, like Krishna, we have to show, Vishnu, we have to show like this because we don't have the accessories. Krishna, we show like this. So without the accessories, that is Pustha and Anga Rachana, there is no makeup of that. If you are, suppose I'm doing a Rakshasa character, a Rakshasi, any character, I cannot color there. I cannot put any costumes, Alankara, decorations. And Sanjeeva, you cannot. Sanjeeva means what? Props that we use on the stage, whether they are living things or non-living things. So it is such a great task for any dancer to present or to do Natya in Ritya. So what the dancer has to do? The dancer has to create everything through her or his gestures and expressions. This is the toughest part. So for this, the dancer should have the right knowledge about the presentation of various bhavas according to the situation on the stage. So when we are portraying a character on the stage, we have to forget ourselves completely and get into the other character and become one with that character by adopting its behavior, temperaments, emotions, gestures, walk, talk, everything. So you are no more there. You are that character. Now suppose you are doing a Ravana, you are Ravana there. Nobody should see you there. Like that you have to. So it should be a total transformation, which is called in Sanskrit Parakaya Pravesham, para, others, kaya, body, pravesham, entering. So entering into the body of another person is called as Parakaya Pravesham. This is what exactly we have to do. This can be achieved through years of sincere practice. You all must be aware of this Parakaya Pravesham. We can see in mythological serials and movies. I hope you have seen this. This power comes from doing the sadhana, which is called as samyamam. So what is samyamam? When mind identifies itself, when the mind identifies itself with the internal impression of the object, leaving the external, the mind identifies itself with the internal impression. Now suppose I want to do you Rama. So I will make the impression in my mind, all the characteristics, everything, and I leave my external what I am. This will be possible by only long practice, and that is retained in the mind, and the mind can get into that state in a moment. Fatak, you will change so many characters. So this power is called as samyamam. When anyone wants to enter into another's body, he makes a samyamam on that body and enters into it. Not only his soul omnipresent, even his mind. Here, while performing on the stage, when we are performing our solo dances, we are not literally entering into the someone's body, as we see in the movies and all. Here, mentally we are penetrating into the character when we want to present that character on the stage. And you all know the entire Srishti is based on the three basic components called Trigunas. What are the Trigunas? Sattvaguna, Rajasaguna, and Tamasaguna. These Trigunas are integral constituents of the mind. These are responsible for a person's physical and psychological behavior or nature. These are the three important characters that lies in all living, non-living, tangible, intangible things. Whatever the vibration emitted by anything are dependent on its predominant, subtle, basic component. And this is what exactly influences the behavior of every creature. Depending upon these three gunas in the individuals, we will get attracted towards that kind of life. So understanding these gunas of the character that we are going to portray is very essential. According to the character, the dancer has to do abhinaya on the stage. When an actor acts exactly like that of the character, like exactly resembling the Ravana or Rama or Krishna or Sita, the prekshakas, the audience, forgets himself and his own identity in the absorption of what is happening on the stage. So here the dancer imitates the original hero or heroine, whatever character, and becomes the attraction to the audience. So purpose of any art form is to create the feeling of rasa, isn't it? We all know that. The enjoyment in the spectator's mind. So to bring out the rasa in the Sahrudaya's mind, the actor has to do the rasabhinaya. Before talking about the rasabhinaya, I want to just tell you what is exactly the abhinaya means. You all know abhinaya is a Sanskrit technical word. The technique of representation, it is referring to the term abhinaya, refers to technique of representation, which is used in communicating the meaning of the drama and calling forth the sentiments. Abhi is the prefix, which means two words. The second part is ni, that is the root, meaning to carry. So abhinaya means to carry towards, or you can say carrying spectators to the meaning. You can call it as you are taking them to the story. So the abhinaya can be called as a vehicle of natya, through which the spectator experiences the particular emotions of the dramatic character, that is to lead him towards the rasananda, the ultimate bliss, which is the aim of natya. The above definite of abhinaya makes it very clear that in terms of ancient Indian dramatic theory, abhinaya does not mean only acting, miming, or facial expressions. the term applies to all the related aspects of histrionics which contribute in conveying the poetic content of the drama to the spectators. The entire human activities are carried out through mind or speech and actions, isn't it? We either we will talk or we show the emotion or we will do the speech. So these three are done by the involvement of chitta, that is mind, vak, that is words, karma, that means actions. These three are together known as trikarana. Many times we hear trikarana shuddhiga, you have to do trikarana shuddhi, that means manasa vacha karmena, you have to do it. So we always hear, so these trikaranas became the sattvika abhinaya, vachika abhinaya and angika abhinaya in the natya, because through that only we'll be conveying. Usually everyone automatically reacts to our pains or pleasures in our daily life, isn't it? So crying and laughing, this will not be called as abhinaya. Then what exactly abhinaya is? When a dancer or an actor suppress his or her own identity, like their own mental condition, their way of actions, their way of speech, walk, everything, and all these things they are suppressed, and then they act or behave like the character or assuming the character, the way the character walks, talks, behave, and totally it will be like that character is walking, talking and doing. So this is called exactly abhinaya means. So the main object of presenting a natya or rupakam or drama content is to bring satisfaction to the audience by evolving rasa in their mind, the transcendental pleasure. So what is rasa? Bharata said, bhavabhinaya, if you want to write, you can write, bhavabhinaya sambandhan, bhavabhinaya sambandhan, sthayi bhavam, stadha budhaihi. Bhavabhinaya sambandham, sthayi bhavam, stadha budhai, aswadayanti manasa, aswadayanti manasa, tasman namya rasasmritaha, tasman nama rasasmritaha. The entire shloka I am repeating again, you can check. Bhavabhinaya sambandhan, sthayi bhavam, stadha budhai, aswadayanti manasa, tasmannamya rasasmritaha. So in the natya, the spectator experiences the joy of rasa when the sthayi bhava associates with the vibhava, anubhava, sanchari bhavas that are present in the kavya, in the literature, what you are doing. Here the most important thing every dancer should remember is the sthayi bhava. What kind of sthayi bhava it is, which will, you know, each sthayi bhava will flourish into the rasa. So which sthayi bhava, I mean, to suppose you are creating the shringara rasa, what sthayi bhava? It is rati, it should be evoked. So to evoke that rati sthayi bhava, what are the vibhavas, anubhavas, sanchari bhavas and sattvika bhavas you have to use depending upon the situation or according to the character we have to use them. These discriminations every dancers must know, for which sthayi bhava we are going to evoke that particular bhavas and vibhavas and anubhavas we have to present. And Bharata said, natyam sattve pratishthitam. Natyam sattve pratishthitam. That means what? Dance lies in sattva. Natya lies in sattvam. So what is sattvam? సత్వం నామ మనఃప్రభావం. సత్వం నామ మనఃప్రభావం, ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఎఫెక్ట్ ఆర్ ద ప్రోడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్, నథింగ్ ఎల్స్. సో యూ విల్ నాట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు సీ ఇట్. యూ కెనాట్ సీ అవర్ మైండ్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్? వీ కాల్ ఇట్ మైండ్, వేర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వీ డోంట్ నో. యూ కెన్ షో ద హార్ట్, హార్ట్ ఈస్ నాట్ మైండ్. Brain, you can show. No, it is not mind. Then where it is? You cannot see it. So, that sattva cannot be. It is only an effect of mana. And it is not visible. That is avyakta rupam hi sattvam. Avyakta rupam hi sattvam. You will not be able to see it. So, Bharata gave such a significant place for this sattva when he spoke about the Abhinaya. He categorized Abhinaya into three categories basing on the sattva. If the sattva is more, that sattvika Abhinaya is more in the Abhinaya, such Abhinaya is called as Jeshtha Abhinaya or Uttama Abhinaya. Among the sattvika Abhinaya, Angika Abhinaya, Vachika Abhinaya, in the three, if the sattvika Abhinaya is more, it is called as Jeshtabhinaya or Uttamabhinaya. If Sattvikabhinaya is moderate, then it is called as Madhyamabhinaya. And if the Sattva is very less, then it is considered as Adhamabhinaya. So, Sattvikabhinaya refers to the performance of emotional state in performance towards the evocation of rasa. So, Sattvika Abhinaya plays an important role in Rasa Prakarana, creating the Rasa in that process. Though Bharata has discussed about Angika Abhinaya, Vachika Abhinaya and Aharya Abhinaya exhaustively in Natya Shastra in various chapters, we cannot find any chapter exclusively on the name of Sattvika Abhinaya, isn't it? Those who have seen Natya Shastra, you know. Because we cannot show the Sattvika Bhavas without the help of action or words, that is Angika or Vachika. So, Bharata discussed about the Sattvika Abhinaya in terms of Samanya Abhinaya. So, there is a chapter, Samanya Abhinaya, where Bharata has explained how to do it. So, what is Samanya Abhinaya? Bharata said, the magnitude, Samanya Abhinaya means the magnitude of Abhinaya with the combination of Angika, Vachika and Sattvika Abhinaya is known as Samanya Abhinaya. I repeat this, Samanya Abhinaya means the magnitude of Abhinaya with the combination of Angika, Vachika and Sattvika Abhinaya is known as Samanya Abhinaya, which helps significantly in Rasotpatti. So, for this Rasotpatti, what Bharata has said? Vibhavanubhava Samyogat Rasanishpatti. That is the definition he has given. How to create the rasa? Vibhavanubhava samyogat rasa nishpatti. When you see this definition, the ingredients he mentioned to create the rasa or to do the rasabhinaya are bhavas, vibhavas, anubhavas, sthayi bhavas, sattvika bhavas, sancha bhari bhavas, etc. So bhavas, 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 full of bhavas. So, what is bhava? Bhavayati karoti rasatva iti bhavaya bhavaha. So, the definition for bhava is bhavayati karoti rasatva iti bhavaha. So, that's why they are called bhava, because they convey the audience the theme of the poem by means of speech, physical actions and mental feeling. Bhavayati karoti rasatva iti bhavaya means they convey the audience the theme of the poem by means of speech, physical action, and mental feelings. And he said, Vavanga Mukharaga Ragena Satvena Abhinayena Cha Kavantargatam Bhavam Bhavayan Bhavamuchyate. I repeat again. Vavanga Mukharagena Satvena Abhinayena Cha Kavantargatam Bhavam Bhavayan Bhavamuchyate. So the meaning brought out by the vibhavas are suggested by anubhavas by means of production of speech, bodily movements, and mental emotions or feelings is termed as bhava. So the bhava reveals the innermost idea of poet, not ours, through the words, gestures, and facial expressions by sattva, that is the chitta, and through the abhinaya. So while doing abhinaya on the stage in a performance, we should not do whatever we want to convey, however we want to do. We have to convey or act for what the poet has explained in the script or in the song. Or whatever is there in the lyrics, that is what we have to show it, not how you want to show. And how you have to show it, how Bharata has explained in the Natya Shastra. Only according to that you have to do. So it is very important to understand the lyrics of the song. The title, that's why I kept understanding the lyrics, is very important, which we are going to perform to understand what exactly the poet is saying or conveying through the song. The word and the meaning are inseparable. It is the two sides of a coin. Sometimes the word may have 2 to 3 or more meanings also. One word will have so many different words. So it is compulsory to know the language to recognize the exact meaning of the word that has been used in the particular context. Unless we understand the meaning, we cannot improvise our abhinaya skill. Suppose you know the meaning by using various hand gestures, repetitions you can do. You know, in Kuchipudi, Vedantam Lakshminarayana Shastri Garu, who introduced the solo system into the Kuchipudi repertoire, only to show Mubba Gopala, the Krishna, he used to show in 33 kinds, various variation he used to show. That means he has the Shastra Parignanam so much. For one word, he used so many different kinds of bhavas. So understanding the meaning of the word is very important. Otherwise, you just, whatever your teacher has told you, you just show that meaning or mudra. Not only that, we must be able to tell the students when you are teaching what is the meaning, and you have to tell the singer, you know, what is the meaning and mainly how to pronounce the word. Sometimes the wrong pronunciation or splitting the word may change the entire meaning of the word which the poet has used. So it is must to know the language and the correct pronunciation and understanding the meaning to express the correct bhava. And also important to split the word. So this mainly applies, you know, when we are watching so many programs, we hear many singers do this mistake while singing new compositions, especially Telugu, Tyagaraja Kirtanas and Annamacharya Kirtanas, when they are singing. Because they don't know the meaning of the word, they break wherever according to the tala. So here, when we are dancing, the importance is the bhava. So when you are breaking properly, if you are not immediately in between, if you are breaking the word, the bhava is disturbed. And it is really very disturbing to the ears of the listeners and the dancers too. So thus creating the rasa bhasa. Rasabhasa means what the exact feeling the audience has to get, that they will not get. That is called as rasabhasa. So it is the responsibility of the dancers to explain it to the singers where to break the word. So first you should know the complete lyrics, how to pronounce the word, what is the meaning. And then you have to tell your students and your singers also. Now, according to the Natyashastra, the portrayal of character is done in three different ways. Bharata said, Anurupa, Virupa, and Rupanusarini. Anurupa, Virupa, and Rupanusarini. This Rupanusarini is also called as Rupanurupam. So what is Anurupa? Anurupa means it is represented by an actor of the same age, same sex. A young boy is as doing as a young boy. A woman is doing of young, same age, same sex, everything. And what is Virupa? A child plays the role of an old man, or an old man takes the role of a child. This is called as Virupa. And what is Rupanusarini? A man plays the part of a woman or vice versa. That is called as Rupanurupam or Rupanusarini. When a man's role is given to a woman, it should be done with great care. What we are doing. Because now the performers are more major in number are women. So we should be doing or portraying the male characters when in Nritya with great care. So the phenomenon of portraying a woman's role by men is there from the early period. Even in the Mahabhasha, they said, mentioned the word Brukumsulu. Brukumsulu means what? Denote a man who was personating a woman's character. He is doing as a woman. This is called as Brukumsulu. So Bharata states that since women are delicate, they should be represented by woman characters only. If suppose they want to portray a male character, that woman should be well versed in the dramaturgic shastra, that is Natya Shastra. The one and only shastra which is talking about dramaturgy is the Natya Shastra. So if you want to portray the male character being a woman, you should be knowing the sutras from the Natya Shastra. And learner teachers who knows the sutras and experienced teachers should instruct the woman in terms of Natya Shastra for the theatrical representation. You need a guidance of a guru or teacher who is experienced with the Natya Shastra, how to portray each character. Because in nowadays we are doing all this Anurupa, Virupa, Rupanurupa, everything in our solo dance presentation. So how to portray them? So the study of Natya Shastra is very, very essential for the right presentation. It is not for MA we studied Natya Shastra. No, it is not for the degree sake. How to improve your presentation, how to improve your technique of presenting your Natya in the Nritya. You have to really understand the Natya Shastra. There is a great variety of characters of male, female, kings, ministers, high officials, attendants. There are so many characters will come in the drama, isn't it? So these characters, how to understand, they are classified according to their nature and their status as Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama. So first we'll talk about the Nayaka, heroes. Depending upon the qualities of the hero, they are Lalita, that means light-hearted, Shanta, they are calm, and Udatta, they are dignified, and Uddhata, they are violent. Now the self-controlled, these all are. The self-controlled and light-hearted hero is Dheera Lalita. He is free from anxiety, fond of the arts, happy and gentle. That is the qualities of Dheera Lalita. Now we see the Dheera Shanta. He is also self-controlled, calm and a Brahmin, or possessed of the generic qualities of a hero. The next one is Dhirodatta. Udatta he is. So he is also self-controlled and glorious hero. He will be having great excellence, exceedingly serious, tolerant, forgiving, not boastful, stubborn or confident, and he is very confident and purposeful. The last one is the Dhirodhata, Uddhata. He is self-controlled but vehement. That is, he will be violent. He is dominated by pride and jealousy. And he will be devoted to witchcraft and deceit, the trickery he is. And he is self-assertive, fickle, irritable, and boastful. Sometimes the Pratinayaka, that is anti-hero, also will have all the qualities of Dhirodhata, that is Ravana and Duryodhana are example. All the kinds of heroes generally comes under the three categories, like Pati, Upapati and Vaishika. This is like Sviya, Parakiya, Samanya. So Pati means the person who marries a woman according to the Vedic rites. The person who marries a woman according to the Vedic rites and maintains the four kinds of Purushartha, the pursuits. What are they? Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. Such person, such Nayaka is known as Pati. He leads his life as a householder and strictly adhere to truth and good ways of life. He is respected. He is the respected lord of his wife. There is no god for her. Her husband himself is the god. Such man is comes under the category of Pati. Now we will see who is Upapati. Upapati is the person who indulges himself in love affairs regardless of the strict rules of life. That is the four Purusharthas. What he said and tied the tali, he will not value for it. Such person is called as Upapati. He is thoughtless and his only goal is love making. The third category is Vaishika. He is the like Upapati only he is, or a degree more, something more above the Upapati he is. And he makes no distinction between the kith and kin or strangers. So far as love making, his passion is for lustful love. He is concerned only about the lustful love. Such person is called as Vaishika, which is equal to Samanya Nayak. And there are Nayaka, Shringara Nayakas, again four categories. They are called as Anukula. This is very important. Anukula, Dakshina, Drishta and Shata. These four categories. So who is Anukula Nayaka? Anukula Nayaka, who is not interested in any other woman and he is very loyal to his wife. Such Nayaka is Anukula. The most example is Rama. And Dakshina. Dakshina Nayaka, who a person who shares his love among his beloved wives equally. That means he will be having more than one wife and he will treat all his wives equally. Such Nayaka is called as Dakshina, so Krishna. So you are, when you are portraying the Krishna character, you should remember that he is Dakshina Nayaka, and when you are portraying the Rama character, you have to remember that he is Anukula Nayaka. The second one is Drishta. When the heroine comes to know about the affairs of his hero or his offense, she rejects him naturally. Even then, he pleads her by folding hands and does all tactics to impress her and gets back her. Such heroes, such Nayaka is called as Drishta. And the last one is Shata. He cheats his adoring and sincere wife. He is known as Shata. So according to what kind of Nayaka, we have to understand and then we have to present them in that way. Now, there are more four categories which helps the Shringara Nayaka. They are known as Pitamardhanudu, Vitudu, Chetudu and Vidushakudu. So, a person who is more or less equal to the hero, a person who is, I mean, almost like a hero he will be, like side hero we will call, no? They are called as Pitamardhanudu. And Vitudu means he will be expertized in Kama Sutra. He is called as Vitudu. And who behaves like a messenger between the hero and heroine Nayaka and Nayika, he is called as Chetudu. And the jovial character is called as Vidushaka. So, you see how many varieties of more are there. I am not going more deeper. At least this much categories we should remember. You all should remember to present on the stage their characteristics. And the character what you are doing belongs to which category. Then only you have to do this. Now I am going for the Nayika Prakarana. Woman generally belongs to the three categories considering their nature. Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama. Because we play more woman characters in Padas, Javalis or Padavarnams. So many places we have to do enact as the Nayika. So this first thing we have to understand these divisions again. So Uttama Nayika. So, Uttama Nayika speaks only agreeable words, even if she is offended. This you have to remember. Uttama Nayika speaks only agreeable words, even if she is offended. Her anger will be short-lived and she will be proficient in fine arts. Noble men will be infatuated by her behavior, beauty, and pedigree. She will have expertise in the art of love, and she will be impartial in her behavior too. Endowed with handsomeness, she becomes angry when provoked, but through her speech, she will not suggest her mood at all. She could understand the truth of the affairs, whether it is true or not, in what condition he did like this, that she will have the mental stability to understand the truth and the situation. Such an accomplished beauty belongs to Uttama Nayika. Then the Madhyama Nayika. A woman of the middling type is the one who reciprocates love and is an expert in the art of sexual activities. She will be envious of the rival woman. Given to an irritating disposition, she would not bear with offense. She will become very angry in a short time. She will regain her calm soon too and become delighted at the slightest reason. Some small gift the Nayaka brings and gives her, she forgets everything. Such a woman belongs to the Madhyama type. Now, what is Adhama kind of Nayaka? Adhama kind of Nayaka will become angry without any sufficient reason. And she is wicked by nature and gets excessive angry. She is fickle-minded, harsh in temperament, and her anger sustains for a considerable time. Immediately, she will not forgive the Nayaka. Now, this is the nature of a woman. According to the nature, women are categorized as Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama. Now, according to the social status, the women are categorized again three. What are they? Sviya, Parakiya, Samanya. Now, let us see what is Sviya. The Sviya Nayika is married and serves her Nayaka in any circumstances, whether they have money or they don't have money, whatever the situation, she will be very loyal to him. And she never leave him. Such woman is called as Sviya Nayika. And this Sviya has again three kinds. That also we should remember. When you are doing a Padam Javali, not just understanding what Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama and Sviya. Again, you have to understand whether she is Mugdha, Madhya, Pragalba. The three categories are there. Mugdha, Madhya, Pragalba. So what is Mugdha? The Nayika, who is very young and shy, having a balanced state of mind, will be silent and quietly weep on seeing the offense, if at all done by her Nayaka. She would be innocent in amorous knowledge and does not give any suggestions to her Nayaka. Such Nayaka is called as Mugdha. This Mugdha, again three are there, you know. Agnata Yavana, Gnata Yavana, and Vishrabdha Navodha. Agnata, she is not aware of her Yavanam. And Gnata, who is knows about her youth. And Vishrabdha Navodha. Then the second category is Madhya in the Sviya. Madhya is in the full blossom of youth. She is shy, still having amorous feelings. And she encourages her Nayaka. Such Nayaka is known as Madhya. In this Madhya, again, they are divided into Madhya Dhira, Madhya Adhira, and Madhya Dhira Adhira. This Dhira, Adhira, and Dhira Adhira are again divided into Jeshta Kanishta. So it will become Madhya Dhira Jeshta, Madhya Dhira Kanishta, Madhya Adhira Jeshta, Madhya Adhira Kanishta, Madhya Dhira Adhira Jeshta, Madhya Dhira Adhira Kanishta. So like this, all these divisions are in the Madhya. The last one is Pragalbha. The Pragalbha is fully mature. She will be having all the skills in amorous sports with her husbands. Such woman is known as Pragalbha. This Pragalbha is almost five kinds. Pragalbha Dhira, in that again Jeshta Kanishta. Pragalbha Adhira, again Jeshta Kanishta. Pragalbha Dhira Adhira, again Jeshta Kanishta. Beyond that, Ratiprita and Ananda Sammohavati. The two other categories are Ratiprita and Ananda Sammohavati. You can, by reading the name itself, what kind of Nayika you can understand. Now the second category is Parakiya. A Nayika who tends to perform adultery in secrecy is known as Parakiya. So this Parakiya is two kinds. Parakiya Kanya and Parakiya Parudha. So Parakiya Kanya, let us understand. An unmarried girl who is under the control of her parents. She is very clever and interested in outing with her friends and behaves innocent with her Nayaka, with her lover. Such girl is called as Parakiya Kanya. The next one is Parakiya Parudha, or you can call as Parakiya Praudha. She is married and behaves according to her husband's will, capable in doing her household duties very well, and she satisfies her husband in all means. Yet, she will be interested in having affairs with other. That's why it is called as parakiya, para, others, kaya, body, interested in some other one's body. So she is parakiya parudha. This parakiya parudha is divided into 9 categories. The first one is gupta, the second one is vidagdha, the third one is lakshita, fourth one is kulata, fifth one is anushayana, the sixth one is mudita, the seventh one is sahasika, eighth one is pratibha chatura, pratibha chatura, or the ninth one, last one is apalapa chatura. Now that is about the parakiya nayaka. The third variety is the samanya nayaka. The samanya nayaka always courageous she is, and she will be having the thorough knowledge in music and dance, and shows her love for the sake of only money. That is the definition of samanya nayaka. That's why she is called as ganika. She is also called as ganika. Samanya nayaka is called as ganika. She would be interested only in rich persons because her ultimate goal is earning money. So she is not bothered he is a lad, young boy or old man. And again, the samanya divided into 3 categories, that is jati, agantuka and gudha. Now whether she is Sviyanayika, Parakiyanayika or Samanya, whatever category she is, or Uttama, Majjama, Adhama, all the women and men will go different avasthas will undergo. That's why Bharata has explained in the Samanya Abhinaya the Ashtavida avasthas. So when the Nayika is in that particular avastha, we call it as that Nayika, like Swadhinapatika Nayika, Vasaka Sajjaka Nayaka, Khandita Nayaka. But it is avastha the Nayaka is undergoing. Okay? But she may be Sviya Nayaka, Parakiya Nayaka, Samanya Nayaka. She may be Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama. Whatever she is. If she is a human being, she has to undergo all these situations. Not only women, even men also will have the same conditions. So the Ashtavida Nayaka avasthas, first one is Swadhina Patika. The Nayika who is having the husband with her, he lives with her and always keep, she is very happy with her husband. That condition is Swadhina Patika. The second one is Vasaka Sajjaka. She dresses up for the union. The Virahot Khantita is distressed due to the separation. Vipralabdha, jilted by the lover. Vipralabdha and Virahot Khantita, you should remember, it is a separation. But Virahot Khantita, she is separated and distressed. Here, Vipralabdha is jilted, cheated by the lover. The next one is Khandita. She is annoyed with her lover because he comes with the early in the but the time where he promised he will, I'll explain that again. Then Kalahantarita, she's entranced due to the quarrel with her lover. Then Poshita Bhadrika, the husband is in exile. And Abhisarika, Nayika approach the lover herself. Now let us go and understand clearly the avastha. The Swadhina Patika is always happy she will be, because her hero is with her and he is fulfilling all her desires. And the Nayaka being captivated by the ways in which she has given him the importance, by the ways of love and the pleasing qualities she possesses. So her status also, celebrating festival of Cupid, interested in outgoing, swimming, etc. The second one is Vasaka Sajjaka. Vasaka Sajjaka is the one who waits in her house, dressed up with ornaments in all eagerness of enjoyment. Vasaka Sajjaka she embellishes herself in eager expectation of love. It is when it is relevant to Vasaka. Vasaka means what? Conjugal union. Understood? That's why she dresses herself and she eagerly expects the arrival of the hero for sure. And she prepares the bedroom with all its requisites and she too dresses up beautifully. So her state is waiting for the arrival of the Nayaka, enjoying with her hand, talking about him to the friends, to her friends and all. The next one is Virahotkantita. Virahotkantita is the one who is distressed due to the separation from the lover, who could not arrive since he is otherwise engaged in several matters. It is not purposely, he did not ditch her. Unavoidable situation, he did not come. So the Nayaka is not coming to her on account of his preoccupation with many other engagements, and she becomes excessively sad that, ayo, my Nayaka is not with me. She will be desperate to meet him. So what she will do? She make use of servants or messengers to run on mission and waits restlessly. Her state is sad. She will be trembling. She will be disappointed and not interested in any activities. She will be shedding tears, sharing her feelings with her friends. The next one is Vipralabdha. Vipralabdha, we should understand the difference between the Vipralabdha, Virahotkantita, Khandita, Kalahantirita. These four are almost very similar, but four are completely different. So, Vipralabdha is that woman who is deceived by the lover, not arriving at the place of meeting on account of some reasons, despite of the fact that a duti has been sent by him. He only said, you come and meet, we will meet here. Papan, this Nayaka will go there, but he will not come. That condition is Vipralabdha. She is prone to lose faith quickly because he jilted and to be tormented in her mind when her love does not turn up. Her state is same, disappointed, sad. She will be sighing and fainting also. The next one is Khandita. Khandita is that woman whose beloved one does not honor the Vasaka. Vasaka means, I said, bed. On account of his attachment with another woman. And she is distressed due to his non-arrival. She receives him early in the morning with ligature marks. She is annoyed. And she's annoyed at that condition, speaks out whatever comes uppermost of her lips. So her state is sighing, silent, mourning, shedding tears, etc. The next one is Kalahantarita. Kalahantarita is a woman who is separated from her lover due to a quarrel or jealousy, and who is excessively anger and impatient. Having no power of discretion, she starts a quarrel for anything and everything. That is Kalahantarita. Later, she feels remorse. Array, I shouldn't have done this. So her state is again, sighing, repenting, muttering, all this will be her characteristics. The seventh one is Poshita Bhatrika. This Poshita Bhatrika is that woman whose husband is in exile or lives abroad on account of very reasonable duties. She wears her hair loose and her state is, she will be only waiting for the auspicious moments for her hero's arrival. Sleeplessness, always lying, not eating, sad, dilemma, etc. The last one is Abhisarika. Abhisarika is that woman who rushes to the request to meet due to love or her intoxicated feeling of love, taking all manners and conventions of modesty. She needlessly spends in adoring herself and boasts over her youthful features and acts. She attracts her lover by her beauty and timely words. This Abhisarika also again two kinds, that is Jyotsna and Neela. So the most important point to be remembered here, when a dancer is portraying these avasthas in Padam or Javali or Varnam or any drama, any character you are doing, first you have to understand what kind of Nayika she is. Uttama, Madhyama, Adhama, first point. Then you have to see whether she is married one, Sviya or Parakiya, Saman. If she is married one, she is Proudha or Mugdha or Madhya, because the behavior is different. If Parakiya, whether she is unmarried or married, Parakiya Kanya or Paruda. Samanya means there is no, you have to really behave like a Samanya. You should not feel, how can I enact? When you are doing a character, you have to do the character like that. You cannot say, Abo, I cannot show all those things. You cannot. So, understanding the lyrics, understanding the bhava, the psychology of the character is very, very important. So, with this, I conclude my lecture. Charanya?
Yes, I am here. Just overwhelmed with your knowledge. It's more like I could say you're like a knowledge house of Natyashastra for us. In fact, I was just browsing through the screens. I think all of us is just so glued to listening to you. Like you're actually telling us Natyashastra like a story to us. It felt like we have just gone into the age of Bharata and reliving what he wrote. Such an amazing session that we've had. And before we could, you know, do the conclusion, do any of you have any specific questions on what ma'am said? And you can kind of unmute yourself and talk if you have any specific questions in the topic that we have just discussed. There's really a lot for us to take in. Maybe we have to sit through our notes again for another couple of days. For us to understand.
Actually, I have prepared this demonstration Kirtana, where in Tyagaraj Kirtana, it is Sri Raghukulamandu Putti Tenu Chekona Rama, because the portrayal of character there in that Sita Swayamvara episode, we come to project Janaka Maharaja, we have to Ravana, Rama, Vishwamitra, and other kings and all. How to portray also is there. If we have time, then I'll do. Otherwise, it's okay. We'll go for the question and answer. And then if time permits, we'll do that. Because they may be having questions regarding the
theory.
I mean, whatever they have heard or understood. Any questions you can ask?
I have one question, ma'am. Like you told us that we really need to understand the lyrics, the language and the poetry. But many a times as dancers, we do items like Varnam and Kirtanam, where we introduce something like this tattumettu and footwork in between the lyrics. One aspect is to capture the audience. But how as dancers can we keep that sthayi bhava or the mood of the song and also deliver this nritta? This is something which is always there when I choreograph a piece.
That is what, when you are doing, like there is a padavarnam which I know I am talking about. Danike tagujanara. Okay, in that the charanas, it is starts. Kamuni keli kaina bamanu cherarara. There we do the sanchari. I mean, like dramatization we do. So the first one or two lines, we'll impart nritya into it, the nritta part, the gestural or footworks, everything. Then we'll go for the drama. After completing the drama, again we'll come back to the nritya. That is what, whether you are doing a padavarnam or a kirtana, when the dramatization comes, before that you have to do the nritya part, the pada abhinaya, padardha abhinaya, because nritya is padardha abhinaya, natya is vakyardha abhinaya. In natya, we don't have to show each word meaning. You don't have to show. It is the essence of the line, you have to show it through the drama. So that is how you have to do. Any other question?
Ma'am, you told about the 9 categories. Can you please repeat that?
Yes. I also had the same thing.
Nine categories?
9 categories of Parakya. Parakya Prouda.
Parakya Prouda. Okay. I have to go back to this one. 1 minute. Just give me 1 minute where it is. Because I don't know by heart. I have to see.
And you told Anushtayana Uddita.
Anushtayana?
No, Gupta. I think it begins with Gupta. Gupta.
Pratibha Chatura.
No, yeah, it is in the Parakya, no?
Parakya Prouda. It begins with Gupta.
Yeah. Parakya Prouda. The 9 categories are write down. Gupta, the first one.
Gupta,
G-U-P-T-A.
Gupta.
The next one is Vidagdha. V-I-D-A-G-D-H-A. I'll spell it. Vidagdha. V-D-A-G-D-H-A. In the 2 categories there, you can understand Vidagdha means clever. She is Vak Vidagdha and Kriya Vidagdha. She can, with her words, she is Proudha. And with her actions also, she is Proudha. Kriya Vidagdha.
Kriya
Vidagdha. Vidagdha.
Ma'am, one more doubt, madam.
Ah.
In the beginning of the session, you said that transitioning from one bhava to the next bhava is samyam.
Okay, 1 minute. We did not complete all these names. Is it okay?
Can we just finish this question?
Sorry. I'm so sorry.
No problem. So, second one is Vidagdha. The third one is Lakshita. Lakshita. The fourth one is Kulata.
Kulata.
Ta. Kulata. Then fifth one is Anushayana. The sixth one is Mudita. The seventh one is Sahasika. Eighth one is Pratibha Chaturya. Last one is Apalapa Chaturya. Yeah, now the one who has asked me about some bhava, she asked, no? Samyamam.
Yes, ma'am. So in the beginning you said that Samyamam
is the power to enter into the character.
Yes, so not that. Okay, yes, miss.
Now, sorry. Suppose I have to, now when you are doing some character,
yes, madam.
You from Rama, suddenly you have to go to Ravana.
Yes, ma'am. That is the doubt, ma'am. How to do that?
Yeah, that needs a lot of practice. You have to really understand that you have to take the training from the guru. How to change? That means when you register, see now in the computer, when you click it, that comes out. Isn't it like that? When your mind, when it is there in the mind, when you think of doing that, tap, now I am Ravana. So I will become Ravana. Now I am doing that. That is why the audience will enjoy the rasa fully. We will be enacting, but we will not be enjoying completely the rasa, because we always, our mind is working. What we have to do next? What Sai Bhava is this? What character is this? All these things will be going in our mind. Our mind will be churning, concentrating on so many things. That's why we will not have the rasanubhuti completely, because we are busy in exhibiting the bhavas. Kumarji, you are there. I am so happy. Kumarji.
Yes. I'm
so overwhelmed because you are there. Thank you.
Yes.
Kumarji is such a senior.
I am enjoying.
Thank you so much.
I am enjoying.
Do we have time? Ma'am, we have like 10 minutes for we have 10 more minutes. If you can briefly take us through the, is it possible for us to understand the characterization?
Actually, you have understood it. If it is demonstrated, I thought doing, otherwise not necessary.
No, we would really love to see the demonstration. I think all of us are just waiting to watch your demonstration. If, you know, it's okay for all of us to stay back for the next 10 minutes. And
if it is okay, then I'll do it.
Sure, ma'am. We are just waiting. We are really waiting, and we will be privileged to watch your demonstration.
Thank you. You are able to hear? I think I'll connect
now
to the...
I think the speaker might be better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think my footwork is not necessary, so it's
Hey!
So mesmerizing and so many characters and just 5 minutes. This is rasa is what you actually was talking to us all this while, and
yeah,
it's really amazing to see this. And we would have surely missed this if we had not watched your performance right
I
now.
Said, you need the samyamam. You have to make samyam with your character. So whenever you want Ravana, come on, enter into me, or I will enter into the Ravana, then Janaka Maharaja, then Vishwamitra, then again Sita. You know, this jumping into the character, we have to first learn from the Guru or understand and put it in practice. This is what I want to convey to all the younger generation.
Such a wonderful session, ma'am. We are really privileged to have you talk about just one small aspect of Sattvika Bhava, and it is moving, it just went on like a poetry and a story to us today, and we are really privileged to have you here. And it was like an icing on the cake when you performed what you actually spoke, so it was, we could just very easily relate to what we wrote down or what we understood in the last 1 hour. I think this just 1 hour or 1.5 hours is just not enough to master the Natya Shastra, and taking your words in, as dancers and young dancers who want to take up dance to the next generation, I think it is a binded duty on all of us to start learning Natya Shastra and understanding that in depth.
That's what, you only don't
then
have
we will be able to take it forward to the next generation.
That's so. What at least you should know what you are doing, the lyrics of the song, whatever you are doing, how to pronounce the word, what is the meaning of that word. And then you do the abhinaya for just without knowing anything, like a puppet, if you are dancing.
Yes.
That is not right. We have
so
to.
And really, I think Gopakumar sir, you've really done a wonderful job bringing in so many of us together. And one way I would say, though artists are not getting paid and monetarily, there is an aspect, but if not for this pandemic, we would surely not have had this connection with you to get so much of knowledge and sitting right at our homes and watching you. I mean, imagine so many of us to flew down from all over the world to watch your performance, and this much of knowledge to gain this is something that Indian Classical Dancers Association is also bringing in artists globally. Such a wonderful thing, and looking forward to interacting with you in a very longer perspective, ma'am. So Madam that Mar- I think Mar- I'm Madam sure. Mar-
are you taking online classes now? Online classes, you are.
Yeah, yeah.
So our members can join your classes, no?
Sure.
Sure. So we will be looking forward to interacting with you more on a personal
connection. Sure, sure, sure. Never to share the knowledge. I'm always with everybody, anybody.
So we are really thankful to you, ma'am, for attending our program. And
that entire credit is yours. See, you being a non-dancer or non-artist, having this passion for the art and promote, you are giving this opportunity. By giving this opportunity, so many youngsters are learning, because it is very difficult to go one guru and learn. By this, these people are getting so many gurus, and each one's way of explanation will be different, approach will be different. So they are getting a platform where they are getting so many gurus' views. So that you are doing a remarkable service, sir. Professor, God bless you. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity also.
Thank you for your valuable time, and thank you for all. I think today we've had more than, now some of the participants have left, but at sometime in the middle there were around 65 or 70 participants today, so which itself kept the entire floor going on. And thank you so much for your time, and thanks everybody for being part of this session. Thank you so much.
So there is no more questions, no? No one has any doubt?
No, I think when we get back to our notes, we will have a lot of questions.
Okay, okay. Anytime you have my number, so you can ask all any doubt.
Yeah.
You can.
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.